Formula E doesn't only bring exciting races to the heart of cities, it also comes with a message. Electric cars could be a future solution to the problem of clean air in our most densely populated areas. One of the holdbacks is charging. With conventional electric road cars, the battery life just isn't long enough to last more than a short commute.
I think the range scares people. I think the hassle of plugging in a vehicle and making sure it's fully charged is a challenge. And I think wireless charging targets both of those issues.
At Qualcomm Telecommunications Services in Munich, a team of people led by Edward van Bohemen have been developing groundbreaking technology that can help restore a workable vision for consumer electric vehicles, or EVs.
It's designed to remove the plug from connecting a car to the wall to charge it up. So we start off with a base pad, which the car has to drive over. We put a current into that base pad. The driver just drives over that pad. The charging starts automatically, and they can just leave whenever they want with hopefully a fully charged battery. And ultimately, that will drive down the cost of batteries, and hopefully the adoption of EVs will take off.
Is this it? Is this the base pad?
Absolutely. So we have all components of a wireless charging system here, starting with the power supply at the back, which puts our 85 kilohertz current in our base pad, and then the vehicle above us has a vehicle pad integrated in the bottom of it. So the field comes from the base pad. It induces a current and voltage in the vehicle pad, which is then controlled and put into the vehicle's battery.
I'd love to see it in practice, though.
No problems. Let's go for a drive.
Can we go for a drive? Excellent. Well, you know, we're sitting here at a traffic light. In a couple of years' time, I could actually charge my car while just sitting here.
Absolutely. This is the prime example of semi-dynamic charging, areas of congestion, traffic lights, or for companies like taxis, taxi ranks as well. So as they make their way along, they can get charged waiting for a ride. And then on a busy road like this one, we'd actually, in the future, hope to see dynamic charging. So anywhere along these main arterial roads, you get continuous power for driving the vehicle as well as charging the battery. As long as the road keeps going, you could keep driving.
And realistically, you know, how efficient is it? Because it's all very well charging these things wirelessly, but obviously I don't want to be sitting for 8 hours.
And we have different power levels, from a slower overnight charge, 3.6 kilowatts, right up to charging in under 1 hour, 20 kilowatts.
Wow, so you could charge it in under an hour?
Absolutely.
I really need to get this.
So yep, just aim for your charging pad there, align with it, keep driving, and you'll get an indication here on this interface to stop.
Oh my gosh! Yes!
Aligned.
Aligned!
Right, let's turn the car off. Let's go get coffee.
With technology like this, a barrier may be removed for consumer buy-in for electric cars, but only the future can tell.